Hello everyone. So in this session, we will be discussing the objectives and the significance of human resource management. So HRM is concerned with the many activities like recruitment, selection, development, appraisal, and motivation of employees. So all these areas will be covered here. So we know that it is a process of determining the manpower needs and formulate the plans to fulfill these needs. Also, in the HRM, we have a set of practices, policies, and programs desire to maximize both personal as well as the organizational goal, means the individual and the general goals of the organization will be achieved with the help of the human resource management. So now the objectives will be discussed one by one. First point, the HRM help the organization in attaining its goal by providing well-trained and motivated employees. So here employees will be considered as human capital or resources for the organization. So their work or their experience, their effort will be assisting the organization to achieve the desired goals. And second point is to employ skills and knowledge of employees efficiently as well as effectively. So there will be utilization of the resources with the optimum manner. Next, to enhance the job satisfaction and self-actualization of employees by encouraging and assisting to realize their best potential. So the HRM, in the evolution we discussed, so employees potential to be identified and it should be utilized at the best level. And next one is establishing and maintaining productive, self-respecting and internal satisfaction of the employees. And very important is a good relationship the organization should have with all the stakeholders. And next, bring out a maximum development of the members of organization by providing opportunities for training and advancement is very important. So once the employee joined the organization, they need to be provided training as well as various developmental programs to improve in their career and improve their knowledge, skills, capabilities. Next, develop and maintain quality of work life. So this point is very important, where employees should be paid a good amount of compensation as well as other benefits, and employees should have a job security, social security, and challenging work, recognition for their work. So all these comprises quality of work life in the organization. And HRM should maintain a high morale and good human relation within the organization, and also help in maintaining ethical policies and behavior inside and outside the organization. So one of the employee in Dabur organization, Dabur company, he followed certain unethical means to achieve some desired target. So immediately the chairman of the company is removed that employee from the company, because the reason is he defended that decision because the companies go with the ethics. It's not go with any unethical means. So we need to achieve profit only based on some ethical policies or ethical behavior. So definitely that will boost the image of the company in the market. To recognize and to satisfy the individual need as well as group needs by appropriate monetary and non-monetary incentives. So monetary incentive means by providing them incentives, bonus, or any other forms of like monetary forms. Non-monetary means recognizing their work or some word of mouth appreciation or giving them challenging work or initiative. So all these things will come. And finally, to manage change to mutual advantage of the individual, group, management and society. So in the second part, we will have a discussion on the significance of HRM. So we know that HR are the valuable asset of the organization, and the human is at the center of all the work, and all development comes only from the human mind. So based on this particular concept, so we have four bifurcation here: organizational significance, social significance, the professional significance, and finally the national significance of HRM. So first one is the individual as well as the individual and organizational significance will be discussed. So it contributes to the achievement of the organizational objectives. So already we discussed in the significance also, the talented and motivated employees, definitely they will contribute their best to achieve the desired objectives. Next, to attract and retain the best talent in the organization, development of skills and attitude, securing willing cooperation from the stakeholders, effective utilization of the resources, not only human resources, but also all the resources should be utilized at their optimum level. And a team of competent and dedicated employees should develop in the organization. Second one is social significance. So some kind of social responsibility should be done through HRM here. So sound HRM has a great significance for the society. So following ways will be considered here. Providing sustainable and productive employment, which might bring them psychological satisfaction. So some kind of contribution you can make to the society here by providing them employment opportunities. Maintaining a balance between job availability and job seekers according to the qualification and the needs. Means giving them employment opportunities here to reduce the gap and solving the unemployment problem. By helping people make their own decisions that are in their interest. And eliminating waste of the manpower of human resources through conservation of their normal energy and their health. And professional significance, also very important in the organization. By providing a healthy working environment, it promotes a team spirit or teamwork in the employees. So this is done through following points. Maintaining the dignity of the employees as the human beings. So here you need to consider them as human beings, not a machine. Providing maximum opportunity for personal development. Providing some training, development, other things. Improving the employee working skill and capacities. Correcting the error of wrong posting as well as proper reallocation of work. Means, for example, if employees are not satisfied with their posting or placement, so the employee should be given the opportunity to work in some other job in which they are interested, so that it will make the employees to work in their best. And finally, the national significance. So we know that the human resource and their management plays a very important role in the development of a nation. So the effective exploitation and utilization of the nation's natural, physical, and financial resources require an efficient and committed manpower. So whatever the resources if a country is having, but if there is no efficient manpower, I think all the resources will be idle. And the level of development in a country mainly depend upon the skill, attitude, and values of its human resources. So in that angle, HR also plays very important at the national level. So these are the fundamental significance of human resource management from four perspective. That is, one is the organizational level, second one is societal level, professional level, and national level. Thank you.